If you own an Insta360 camera and already have some video editing experience, DaVinci Resolve is such a good choice for an editor. It can edit regular video projects to a high level, it can edit 360 videos, and it's free. Need I say more? The main benefit to reframing in DaVinci Resolve is it means you don't need to constantly go back and forth between Insta360 Studio and DaVinci Resolve if you need to make changes to your reframing on the fly. For example, if you're editing to music, sometimes you need to change the framing to be a second earlier, a second later, and doing it here in the same editor that you're already using for your project is going to save you so much time in the long run. Now, this video was sponsored by Insta360, and all shots that I'll be editing in DaVinci Resolve were shot with the Insta360 X4, which I'll link below. So the editing workflow starts right here in Insta360 Studio, where as normal, we're going to stitch our shots and export them in the 2x1 equirectangular format. To do that, with a clip selected, head down here and click this yellow button, and instead of export reframed video, head over to export 360 video. This will export it at the correct dimensions. Change the bitrate to 100 since 200 is overkill, and I'd recommend H.265 as the encoding format. Now click start export, and this will stitch our shots and save them to our computer. Once you've stitch your shots, you'll want to download the DaVinci Resolve editing software by following the link below. Now you'll see there's a free version and a paid version of DaVinci, and which one you choose is up to you. I'd absolutely recommend starting with the free one and paying for it down the line if you like it. The main benefit of the paid version for 360 content creators is you can export up to 32K video resolution, which is crazy, which means if you're shooting and editing for VR, you can get really high quality timelines and projects, and you're not limited to 4K like you'll get in the free version. However, if you're only shooting 360 videos just to reframe them into a flat, normal perspective, the free version is going to be fine, since you can set projects up to 4K resolution, which is really high resolution for a flat video. Now let's get into it. To reframe in DaVinci, you're going to need to download a third-party plugin. So if you follow the link below, you'll find yourself on the KartaVR plugin website. And if you scroll down, you can download this plugin by clicking this button here. Now open up DaVinci Resolve and head across to the Fusion tab. Drag and drop the newly downloaded file into DaVinci Resolve and then click Install and Launch. If this produces any errors, choose Custom Install Path instead, and choose anywhere on your hard drive, and then go back and then install and launch again. This will prompt a loading screen, which when it's done will open up a new Finder window, which you can exit out of. Now you'll need to be patient and wait for the plugin to install. For me, this took around 2 to 3 minutes. Once it's done, it will bring up this new menu. Next, choose the KartaVR option on the left hand side of the screen, and then scroll down until you find Reframe 360 Ultra. Click the checkbox to download it. Once it's done, exit out of this window and you should be good to go. You may want to restart DaVinci at this point to give it a chance to refresh with the new plugin installed. Once you've reopened it, head over to the Edit tab and then go File, Project Settings. Then in the Image Scaling menu, change mismatch resolution files to stretch frame to all corners. What this does is it stretches our equirectangular videos into a 16x9 video, which will help avoid black holes top and bottom. Go ahead and save that, and now it's time to import our footage. So here's one of my clips I'm going to drag and drop onto the timeline. I'm going to quickly trim the top and tail, and now let's reframe. Under the Toolbox tab on the left hand side, head down to Effects and open this menu. Here you'll find a new option, KartaVR, and in here is the Reframe 360 Ultra plugin, which is the one that is going to reframe our footage. So go ahead and drag this effect onto your clip. You can see that the clip has already reframed itself here in the main viewer. To reframe your shot, click on your clip and then head up to the inspector in the top right corner, and here under the Effects tab you'll find the plugin, which is made up of different parameters that you can change to reframe your 360 video however you like. There's field of view, which is zooming in and out, pitch, which is up and down tilt, yaw, which is panning, there's roll, which is moving the horizon line, and then there's rectilinear projection, which is essentially fisheye. I know it would seem like this tiny planet projection option would be a good choice, but I found it to be not so helpful because it distorts the borders and adds those extra repeated fields of view around the outside. So you want to avoid this slider. Whereas instead you can get the tiny planet effect by adjusting the rectilinear projection and then fine tuning the field of view, the pitch, and the yaw. Now to reframe with keyframes, first you want to navigate to the start of your clip. Find the first viewpoint you like by adjusting these sliders. Then on the right hand side, you'll find keyframes. Click one to lock the parameter in place. Now to create a camera movement, move your playhead along the timeline to the next position. So I want mine to be about here and adjust these sliders until you're happy with the new viewpoint. By default, keyframes will be added anytime you move the sliders. Now when we play that back, it transitions from one viewpoint to the other. Now you can go ahead and repeat the process as much as you like. If you want to hold on a viewpoint for a few seconds, set your keyframes, then play the video forward and just add the keyframes again. So repeat the process as much as you like and add keyframes, get creative, try things out. You can always play your work back as you're going and fine tune it as you go. Now, if you want to make changes to a keyframe, you'll need to find the exact point on the timeline. You can do so by pressing left and right on your keyboard until you find it. You'll know you found the spot when you see the keyframes light up here on the right. So now I can adjust it accordingly. Now at this point, the video does look good, but I think we can make it even better yet again by making the transitions between the viewpoints smoother. To do that, click this button here in the effects window, which will take you to the Fusion tab. Close the inspector by clicking on it, then open up the spline menu. Click the check mark next to KartaVR Reframe 360 Ultra, and this will display all the parameters we just set as keyframes along the timeline. To get all of the keyframes in frame, just click on this button here. Now each of the dots along this timeline represents one of the keyframes that we set in the previous menu. And the line in between the keyframes represents the speed at which it transitions. So a steep transition like this one means the transition's faster, whereas a smaller hill like this one means it's slower. Now to smooth these transitions out, click anywhere on the spline panel, then Command or Control A to select all. Next, head down to this button here and click it. Now you'll see that our transition lines are no longer sharp, but they're smooth, representing smooth transitions. You can also adjust individual keyframe transitions here by moving the handle up or down to help change the speed and length of that individual transition. Definitely take the time to learn this spline window because it's very powerful and it will take some getting used to, but when you do, you're going to have so much control over your reframing. Always be sure to play back your video as you're reframing to see how your animation looks. As you'll see, sometimes it plays back a bit slow in this menu, in which case you can head back to the edit tab and give it a play. Now it should play back much more smoothly. And there we go. We've just reframed this video with smooth, catchy keyframes, and it was all done right here in DaVinci Resolve. So go ahead and drag in as many clips as you like and reframe them following this process. I know it seems complicated at first, but most of the complication is in the setup. Once you've done that, you'll be good to go and reframing at lightning speed. And that's it. That really didn't take long and the results are very impressive. And now that you know how to reframe awesome 360 videos in Resolve, next you're going to need to learn how to shoot amazing content with your Insta360 camera. If you want to get all of my best tips and tricks for doing that, you'll find them inside my 360 Video 101 course, which I'll link below. And if you liked what you saw in this video and you've decided that DaVinci Resolve is the editor for you, but you still haven't taken the time to learn the basics of how to set up a project and do basic editing, check out this video here. Inside it, I'll teach you all the basics you need to know to get up and running in just 12 minutes.